force submit. Looks like I got this, guys. Look at this. They're all...
mute so you guys can hear me. Unmute Sam, just give me 1 second. Hey Sam, you there?
Yeah.
Okay. I am just finishing setting this up. Guys, so just give me 1 second. All day, and Sam can attest to this, we were having a lot of internet and cable issues, and like it seems like it's subsided for the most part, but right now it's having a, like, some of the stuff is having some issues, and it looks like setting up the stream was not as smooth as it usually is. Like the options for the different servers for Twitch was showed that none of the ones that I could choose were, you know, great options, which kind of worries me. So this will be a it's gonna be a normal stream as long as the internet cooperates. If it doesn't, well, we might what I could do is we could continue like filming this and then use the footage that we had live and then attach it with this with like an off stream like video that we did continuing the build for the rest of the footage. But I don't know, we'll see what happens. The internet looks like it's cooperating, but you know, it could change, so we'll see. Anyway, welcome to the stream, Sam, of course.
Thank you. Don't forget to share my screen so I can see what you're doing.
I mean, share my screen, not your screen.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
But, yeah, guys, so, we are live now, so Sam's back on the stream. This is the 11th. Rainy River live stream, I think. So we are probably getting towards the end of at least like this first part of the series. We may take a little bit of a break before Cities Skylines 2 comes out. So if not this week or next week, maybe the week after, I'm not sure, but we'll see what happens. Like I think a good goal would probably be like last series city build we did last year when we did Farmingdale. Yeah, we got to about 25,000 citizens. So I think that's about a good goal to reach before the end of the series or the end of the first sort of season of this series if we ever come back to it, you know. I mean, what would you think of that, Sam?
Yeah. That's a good idea.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea too. But before we get into it, before we get to the game, I just want to go over my usual spiel, so hang tight, we'll get to it in a few minutes. But first, if you haven't done it already, and you feel so inclined, I would greatly appreciate it if you guys could follow me here on Twitch. It means a lot, you know, I'm a small streamer, so like every little thing helps. Helps me out, definitely, because, like, I'm trying to reach my first goal of reaching 40 followers, and it would mean a lot. I'm within 10 now. I got my 30th follower, I think, last week, and so that really does help, because it helps build a community here. It helps lift my prominence up just a teeny bit more, you know? It's not a big thing, but hey, you know, like it starts a what could hopefully be a chain reaction of things. Maybe I get a bunch of followers like right after I get yours. You know, I hope that I can show you guys that, like, or I hope that what I do, this being a hobby and all, will get you guys to come back week after week, and it would show that you guys like what I'm doing. It would encourage me to continue this series, continue other series that we do. And just, it helps encourage me and motivate me to stream more to you guys and you know, just come on and hang out and stuff like that. It really encourages me and motivates me to do that, and I would definitely greatly appreciate it. If you have any suggestions on ways that I can improve the stream, or games you want to see us play, or just any sort of constructive criticism or suggestion in general that will get you guys to come back for another stream, or more than one stream, or whatever, you guys can let me know here on the Twitch chat or in the suggestion box below. For the Twitch chat, I know that the shield is still on, so I'm going to have to find a way to lessen the restrictions without being too lenient on it. It's just because I've been getting a lot of like bots appearing in the chat, and it's been really annoying to have to stop the stream, go in and like delete the messages. So that's why the shield is on, but I keep forgetting to go on and like lessen the restrictions so that you guys can actually chat where you should be able to. Also, like I said, in this suggestion box, I will do my best to constantly check that and the Twitch chat as much as I possibly can and reply to all the suggestions that you guys have. And the ones that I can't, you know, I don't mean to, but, you know, sometimes it happens. I will see which ones I can realistically implement. Again, you know, there are certain games that I just wouldn't be able to see myself playing. So there's would be really no point in us playing it. But, you know, don't let that stop you from mentioning any games that you would like to see us play. Anything that you guys have that would improve the stream, the quality, you know, things that you think would get other people watching as well. It's all greatly appreciated. If you want to stay up to date with everything that's going on with this channel and the Twitter and the YouTube channel, you can follow me here on my Twitter handle at allegius961109996. That is where I post whenever I'm going to be live, whenever I can't be live, whenever I update the schedule, basically anything that goes on with this hobby, it will be put there first. So you can stay the most up to date there. You can also follow me or subscribe to me over on YouTube, Allegius Plays. That is where I post all of these live streams after they premiered here. So you can go over there if you want to rewatch this episode and the VOD was deleted from Twitch. You can find it over there. So if you want to subscribe to me, that's the best way. That's one of the best ways to help me out over there. It would help build a smaller or it would help start to build a community over there. Also liking the live streams so that it gets picked up by the YouTube algorithm just a little bit more. Sharing the live stream so it gets the word out. They generally go up within the first 24 to 48 hours after they premiered here, just depending on how fast it takes to upload the video, how big the video is, the internet speed, the quality of the internet at the time, you know, or the quality of the internet connection and stuff like that. But generally you can expect this one to be up either tomorrow or Wednesday, depending on those factors. But with that being all said, let's get into the game. Let's see where we left off and continue our build. That's weird.
What?
Oh, there we go. That was weird. The game didn't appear on the live stream for a few seconds. Oh. Yeah. It was very strange.
The internet might still be a little buggy.
Might still be having issues, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we still have the aftermath of that giant tornado here on the over here. All right. So we're gonna have to delete those. We're gonna have to fix that street. And the game is like super buggy right now. Oh gosh. Let's upgrade these. Doesn't mean you shouldn't have pants. Pair new apparel. What were we gonna do last time? I can't fully remember, but oh yeah, didn't we? I think we had plans to do something with this area. I just can't remember what we were gonna do.
I think you said we were gonna have a forestry industry or something.
No, forestry was gonna be over here. Remember?
Okay.
We could make it another. We could make it another park.
Yeah.
We can make it more like a nature reserve, maybe, or a zoo. I mean, what would you think?
I think a zoo.
A zoo? Okay. Let's start filling in our housing. There isn't a lot of demand, so we'll put these there. So we got what's cool is that we play this game on the day that the dev diaries come out for the second game. So it's really neat to be able to like talk about it like the day of that they've released or that they released the dev diaries. excuse me. Did you get a chance to see the dev diary?
No, I haven't.
Ooh. Uh-oh. Wait, what? Are we running out of electricity again? What is going on? Okay. Where is our power plant? I think we're gonna need another one. How much money does this cost?
$200,000. The power plant.
Be in debt a little bit, but it would produce how much? 640 kilowatts of electricity. So let's delete these two coal power plants. We'll move this gas one over here. And we will put in... Whoops. We'll put in... That might not be the best bet, but... We're gonna extend this road here. Oh, wait, I shouldn't have unpaused the game. Uh-oh, okay. Quickly plop this in right here. There, now we got a nuclear power plant. This should take care of our electricity for a while. Yup, look at that, it's all... The power is completely fixed because of this. Now, what's going to be neat is that they've already showed that like the power plants and stuff like that are going to be very modular. So instead of having like a bunch of power plants like just along the same street, you can have like multiple of them, or you can put like an extra reactor here. Or two more reactors, so they get more, you get more out of one power plant instead of putting, like, constant, like, more and more and more electricity, or more and more power plants. I mean, would you prefer that over like how we have it now, or like what are your thoughts on that?
The power plants.
Like the modularity of the, like being able to like add on to like the service instead of constantly having to place like power plants next to each other more and more and more. Instead, you'll be able to put an extra reactor to make the power plant put out more electricity than what it was.
Yeah, I like, you know, like that what idea.
Now, why do you like that idea? Like, what do you like? I'm trying to get you involved in this, you know? Like,
it's a good idea, because then you don't have to keep plopping it down, and then it saves room for other stuff. Like, it's just, it's not only, room saving, but it's also just better.
Okay, would you like to expand on that? Like, what makes it better, do you think, other than, like, the room? Do you find it to be, like, more...
It's just easier, you know, like, because if it were me building a game like this, I would probably... And this is me. I would just build one gigantic power plant that could, like, that would be just that you would only need one of, and just swap it down, and then that's it. It'll power the whole city, no matter how far you go.
Now, I don't know. Well, there might be a couple of problems with that, because think about it this way. What happens if that area gets completely pummeled by like an earthquake or a tornado, or like, because I think you've seen, like, we have like our power plants like sort of concentrated over here. What happens when, like, a tornado hits over here and completely destroys the city? Yeah. Or completely destroys the reactor? So you gotta think about it, like, there's a thing called redundancy, in the sense that, like, there's a reason why, like, you make more than one connection for, like, water. Like, let's say, for example, let's say... this right here, there's a reason why, like, people will put like water pipes going along like all of these different streets, because let's say this water thing gets, like, let's say this area gets destroyed by a sinkhole. Well, then if you only had this one, there's no water at all, but if you have this one added to it, you have a backup just in case, because water can be diverted over here. So it might be, while it might be more efficient to, it might be more efficient to build one big power plant, you might also need to think about, okay, I have a big power plant, but, the downside is that do I leave it like that, or do I put, like, build another area with another power plant somewhere else, so just in case that one blows, I have the other one there to pick up the slack, so that, you know, we lose parts of the city to electricity, but not all of it gets lost. That, like, do you get it, or?
Yeah, I get it.
Like, would that make you think more? Like, okay, I want to have a big power plant, but what if that one gets destroyed?
Well, I mean, you can place more. Like, you know, I just, for me, it would drive me nuts to just swap. Keep swapping them down every 5 seconds.
Yeah. What I'm saying is, like, a mixture of both may be, like, the best way to do it. Of, like, having medium-sized, a couple of medium-sized...
Yeah, that would work.
You know, a couple of medium-sized...
Yeah, that would work. I mean, as long as, like, this medium size, like, right now, I guess we have, what, smalls? Would you say small?
Well, yeah, single power plants that can't be modular, like, can't be modded in any way.
Yeah,
so, like, in the game, it would probably be, in the sequel, probably be considered, like, just a small power plant, like a single powered power plant, you know? Whereas, like, in the sequel, you'll be able to plop down, like, an extra reactor or more storage for coal or uranium or whatever the power plants use.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Having, like, medium size would be better. So that way you're not plopping them down so often.
But you also have redundancies, just in case.
Yeah.
Oh God, we may have to... Oh no. No, actually, traffic is still... So build a couple of more... We can build a couple of more houses over here. Although, no, there's not really that much space, is there? And the problem is it's going to also have a lot of noise pollution.
See, I wonder if that's going to be something they're going to do too, is, like, try to, like, I know there's no way to, like, well, okay, I'm going to sound really dumb here, but, and I'm already laughing at myself because it just sounds so stupid, but I'm wondering if there's going to be a way that they're going to, like, maybe lessen the... Like, still put things in that, you know, would cause noise pollution and stuff like that, but not cause it as bad or as much, you know?
Well, I mean, some people have had gripes about the noise pollution mechanic. Some people have been like, oh, it's too much. It's like there's... You know, people can handle more noise pollution than what's been in the game. You know, so, like, they've... Oh, they've said, like...
Or you can just turn it down or off or, you know...
Well, that sort of mechanic, it's hard. That's hard to do, to, like, just put it in the game. Although, I mean, I guess you could put it in as a slider... But it would take a lot because, like, a lot of things affect, there's a lot of things that it affects. So you would have to take that into account too. You need to make sure that the game is playable.
Right. Yeah.
That's the thing. Cause if, like, somebody does something and it's, like, just a slight thing and it, like, let's say they change the noise pollution by a percentage. We don't know how sensitive the mechanic actually is. It's like, how do we know that... Oh, we got ourselves a follower. Let's see. I'm gonna Give me 1 second. I will take a look. Thank you for following, Metzmerize? I think it said before it flashed away. Thank you for the follow. Let me see. Hasn't come up in the news feeds. Oh, yep, there we go. Metzmerize. Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the game. We are just building our beautiful, it's kind of like a conglomeration of settlements. It sort of started as like two towns, and then it sort of grew together, and now we're starting like another little area over here. And we're struggling with water yet again.
And we're trying to protect it from disaster.
Because it's gotten hit multiple times.
Yep.
I got it. Yeah. I'm gonna just build. I'm gonna.
What's next? The herd of rhinos?
Now, I wouldn't be surprised if somebody tried to make a mod for that. Like, just the most ridiculous things. Like how SimCity had the aliens. Do you, Link, do you remember that when they you had the ability to like unleash aliens on your city and they would come
I never did it.
Oh, and the game never did it to you?
No.
Or did you turn off disasters?
I don't think I ever had it on.
Oh, wow. Lucky you. You didn't get just completely rocked by aliens coming in and just abducting all of your citizens. All of your helpless citizens.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, why are you? Oh, both. Wait, does that not have electricity? Really? Okay. Okay, I gotta pause this because I gotta. Ah, this is annoying. Also, gotta put in. Yeah, I think it's time that we replace these outflow pipes to like water treatment plants, water treatment facilities, because the eco water treatment facilities, like we can fit one there and then a second one there. This should solve the issue, but hopefully. So let's see, did it solve it, or was there? Really? Okay, there we go. We're probably gonna have to add another one because there's. Where is Eco Inland Water Treatment Plant? So it'll take some time, but this should clear up now once, like, now that all of the outflow pipes are gone.
Mm-hmm.
At least we hope, you know?
Yeah. I don't think you can get rid of the outflow pipes.
You could. You just replace them with a treatment plant.
Oh, I didn't know that. Really?
You, like, you didn't look in the, what are they? The water section? You didn't check to make sure that there was
look, but I guess I never got that far, so I was still in the city.
Oh.
Because as I said before, I would get started and then just completely forget about it.
Mean. Wow. Forget about your own citizens. That is really mean.
Yeah. I don't mean to be mean. I just... I wouldn't do that if I was an actual mayor, though.
You sure about that? But yeah, they have, I'll show you the options in a second. I just want to make this another district here. Go. Yeah, we have to come up with a better, actually, I kind of like that name for this area.
What?
Primrose.
You mean the town like of Primrose Everdeen?
Yeah. Well, I guess that's what it's. Well, it's they. She was named after an actual flower, a real flower.
Yeah, I know.
Primrose Farm.
But when you said that, I was like, it just snapped in my head. I'm like, oh, like the honeybee and the flower.
Yeah. Primrose Township. We are going to add, to continue the growth in this area, we will add, oh, that's 4. Need 5. Cattle. Also add a milking parlor. We're probably going to need what is it? More farms here, so we will get another road. But yeah, as I was saying about the the new dev diary though that just came out today, they were talking about like zoning and what they now call signature building. They are kind of like unique buildings here that provide like tourism and extra city bonuses and stuff like that, but only they are they're basically like normal residential, commercial, and industrial buildings that you can plop, which provide different bonuses to the city. So you will find like, there's one called like a, software park or something like that. And what it does is that it gives you like different citywide bonuses for, it being there, for placing it there. Oh god, okay, so we're gonna need to move this road because that is not gonna fit. But yeah, they like the different things that they talked about, like it's really interesting to see the new mechanics that they put into the actual game. And As people already know, people can already hear, I am very excited for this game. I know that a lot of people, some people have criticisms of it, and I'm fine with that, but it's like, you know, you can't expect them to give you everything that you want. It's just not how it works, you know? Like, some people wanted, like, things that are just really difficult to put into the game, and a lot of people, like, the biggest, I think, disappointment people had was multiplayer. And it's like, do you not realize, guys, like, not only did SimCity completely fail at multiplayer, but we want to, like, I'm sure Colossal Order would rather focus on making a solid single player experience first before even attempting a multiplayer version of this. I mean, it'd be fun if we could do a multiplayer series of you and I building a city and trading resources and stuff like that, but wouldn't you rather see a complete game first before you see that? You know what I mean? Like, wouldn't you rather see a complete game before?
Yeah, I would.
Like, even if that means single player, right? It's like, I'm fine. We're fine, like, just being on a call like this and saying, hey, let's build this. I'm gonna speed up time so that it gets back to the daytime. I know that we can turn off, day night if we wanted to, but hey, I like the cycle between it sometimes. But yeah, the zoning is very interesting too. It has a different sort of mechanic now. They've got, there's six different residential zoning now. So there's more than these two. There's now a total of six. So they are single. The first one is like single family homes like this, like we see here, single family homes.
Yep.
And then we have like middle density housing from like row housing. Do you know those like buildings that are kind of pushed together, like not I guess you can call them townhouses. They're like attached together, but they're attached together, and then there's a huge row of them along the street.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They also have medium density apartments. They then have high density apartments, and then smaller density they have large density apartments, and then apartments that are like a lot smaller. They're apartment buildings, but a lot smaller, so that you can fit more people into them. You know what I mean? Like the one, like studio apartments, kind of.
Yeah.
Think of like studio apartments.
So if I wanted to make like a small town and just keep it a small town, and then make like a big city beside it, I can do that.
Oh yeah. Now, the big new thing about the game is that when you know how like with population milestones, you can only unlock the land around you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now that's no longer the case. You start off in one of the squares, and then when you go to buy a new piece of land, you can buy any tile you want. It doesn't have to be next to the start square. You can start it anywhere. And those towns will start like trading between each other using the highway that's outside of your city, using the connections that are outside of the town to trade with each other. So the area you own in the area you own inside, like in your lands, don't have to connect to each other. So you can build a bunch of small towns and then a decently sized city in the distance that will sort of like act as suburbs.
Yeah. So that's what I've been thinking of doing, right? I'm going to do it in the city skyline, but like...
Well, you can. All you do is just...
I know I can. It's just... I just haven't had the,
Because, I mean, look at what we've done. We started with a small... Yeah. Two small settlements, and now look at them. They're massive. Also, I think they've, I think they've done a, they had a good idea with allowing us to choose where we buy the tiles instead of having it to be having them bought like in a contiguous manner.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we have to deal with this. Oh yeah, I forgot about this. I'm not seeing what is causing this bottleneck. I mean, it's flowing at least. Okay, anyway, yeah, I was hoping that this would be an alleviator, but I guess not. But yeah, the other big zone that people are excited about, mixed use. There's mixed use zoning now. Do you know what that is?
So it's like the houses on top and the businesses on the bottom?
Yes, commercial on the bottom floor, and then the rest being apartments on top.
So it's like business in the front, party in the back.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, but it's like people are really excited about because I mean, it's something that we don't have now, but it's realistic. It's realistic. Yeah. I mean, if you go downtown Toronto, you're bound to, like, you see it constantly where you see either an office building with commercial on the bottom, or you see apartment building with a convenience store underneath, you know, or coffee shop.
Yeah.
No, I think that's really nice. I think that's a really good idea that they finally added it in. I think that was a great idea that they had. Yeah. And I'm glad that they were able to implement it. Mm-hmm. I think it's time that we put an elementary school over here. And then the other thing they have is they talked about land value, like, so where like the richest areas are, like where the biggest demand is. They talked about like where, like if you're next to the shore here, you're gonna have higher land value. If you have more amenities, the land value will go up, which means the rent will start to go up in those areas, making it tougher for poorer citizens to move in. And so they said you have, like, land value is good, but it's also something that you have to manage as well, because if it goes too high in a certain area, nobody's going to be able to afford it, and so you're going to have to. So the reason for that is now is that what's going to happen now is that, like, when that happens, when you have, like, high land value in a certain area, like, for example, what we've been doing here, if you noticed, there's a reason why this has been turned into, like, high residential, right? Because of the land value.
Yeah, because it's green.
Yeah, but the reason why, though, Sam, why is it such high land value? Why is it such high land value?
I don't know, because everyone wants to live there.
Exactly. There's a lot, but why does everyone want to live in this area, though?
Because it has everything it needs.
The amenities are good. You have a park here. You have a police station, a university nearby. You have medical services over here. You know, you got a lot of stuff. That's why the land value has gone up. Which means the rent has gone up. Which means if people want to live there, they're either going to have a lot more high-paying jobs, or you're going to have a lot of citizens moving in to be able to take care of the rent. So there, that's the thing. That's why, like, when you have these smaller buildings here, the land value is so high. The land value is so high that the people here won't be able to afford it. So you need to build more housing in that area, so that more people can move in and pay the rent. So that's why in the second game, you'll have to redevelop these areas to be higher density. You know, like, do you,
yeah.
You get it? Like, yeah. You get what? Like, is that going to be too confusing for you, or, like, what do you think of that?
I mean,
like,
I can probably figure it out, like, just...
What do you think is going to be the challenge for you, is...
Yeah. It's, I mean, everything's a challenge for me, so... But...
Yeah, but the easier thing is, what you have to remember is, okay, the land value is high... Which means a lot of people want to move in, but there's a very limited amount of space, right? There's a very limited amount of space. So you have to either try to get wealthier citizens to move in, or you have to build a higher density so that more people can come in. Mm-hmm. Policy. Okay, let's add a policy. Do an advertisement campaign. We're gonna make this one. Yeah, this is the main park. Do fireworks. Oh, okay. We are in debt, so we're gonna have to be a little more careful. But like, from what you hear, what do you think is going to be the biggest challenge for you overall in the new game?
Oh, so we got
academic works here. We got two of them. All right. Nice. So we, we moved up. We reached level achievement recognized. So we went from unrecognized to recognized. Nice. So the more we level up here, the more prestigious our university or our institute is going to be. So we want to keep working towards leveling this up. So the next level, we have to have 450 attractiveness. We need 631 students and 2 of 4 academic works. So we got to make sure our conveyor belt education system allows for it. So we need to make sure that we have the capacity in our elementary schools and our high schools to help that grow, help that number grow. Slow that down. But yeah, what do you think is going to be the biggest challenge for you for the new game?
Probably keeping everything managed. And learning everything. Because this is like, it's like they're building a whole new game, but it's the same game.
Well, that's the point. They wanted to reimagine the game, right? Mm-hmm. Hold on. I'm trying to figure out which one we were doing. Did we do university campus or did we do trade school? I think we did. It's a new game, or it's the same game, but new.
Yeah.
They have new mechanics, but they're trying to do it in a way that not only gets old players to swap over to the new game, but also get new players in that can learn how to play it and not feel like completely lost in what they're doing.
I mean, like, for me, I have never put like trains in my city. I've never put buses.
Well, how long have you spent on one city? Like, that's a big question. Like, how?
Not very hard.
Like, okay, so what was the big things that you would get stuck on?
Honestly, I look at my city and I find that, because when I look at your cities, they're like smaller and compact and they're really, you know, nice. Like, I know there's no...
You call this small? It's fairly wide.
But it looks like an avocado, actually.
this one does because of the way the map is.
Yeah. But I think the thing for me is the fact that, like, there is no way to... There is no way, like certain way to build a city. I know that. But my OCD kicks in and it's like, no, that's not right. That's not right. That's not right. You're building too big. You're building too, you know, you're not building right. You're doing it all wrong. Just, oh.
Well, it's, well, I mean, the thing that they've always said is, look, we are trying to help, like, they are trying to help you make the city of your dreams, the city, a city that you would want to live in,
yeah.
You know? So, it's like, you build it in a way that you could see yourself actually living there. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm guessing the way you're talking now, you're not really fond of the way any of your cities actually turned out.
Yeah. That's like, probably why I didn't continue them, or I just deleted them. But then again, I do that with everything, like every game that I play.
So you should try to, like, tell yourself, okay, calm down. It's not that bad. I can fix this.
Yeah.
You know, like, just take it slow. Take it one step at a time. And I mean, I'm not saying, like, the thing is I'm not amazing at this game. I've seen people, like, I just cannot be, like, for me, I cannot be bothered to go into as much detail as some people have with this game. And, like, the cities that they create, it's just, they amaze me with the amount of time and detail that they dedicate to their cities. And I'm sitting here thinking, like, oh my god, all of my cities are just all grid-like, and they're building, like, these amazing fantasy cities that, you know, just completely outdo everything, like, I could have ever, like, I could have ever imagined.
Yeah.
So, I'm not perfect either. Like, my stuff is not perfect.
Well, to me, you seem like you, like, you're an expert at the game, to be honest.
I, like, don't want to sound, like, I don't want to sound full of myself, you know? Like, I don't want to But I do have, let's see, at this point, on July 10th, 2023, ever since the game came out, I have a total of 2,707.9 hours in the game.
Let me see how many hours I have. I'm scared to look. Give me a second here.
Hey, if anything, I should be the one scared of my own thing. It means I don't have a life.
Yeah, you have a life.
Not by the way of the number of hours I've spent playing in this game.
How many hours did you have?
2,700. Let me check one more time. 2,707.8 hours. Yeah.
I have 61.5.
Only 61.5?
Yep.
Wow.
That's how often I play the game.
Okay, yeah, you haven't played a lot.
Because
you just get, like...
Yeah.
Oh, but really? Also,
well, I mean, I'm wondering if... I haven't even gotten any of the, like...
Any of the most recent DLCs?
Yeah. Like, I don't know how many DLCs I have.
You can check, like, look in your...
Let's see. I have, if I can get it up. I don't know if... I'm looking at the DLC area, but I don't know if these are mine or if they're from the store.
Well, if you're looking on the store, you'll be able to see that the thing says in already in library or something.
Right. Okay. So.
Is I'm just gonna. Can I get by here?
Square Packages, the packaging specialists, are proud to present a box on both your houses. The untold story of the invention of the box and the family rivalry that nearly destroyed it. It's a tale about opening your heart, finding acceptance, and inventing the most efficient means of shipping and packaging them.
I mean, I don't think
holy
I...
cow!
Proving that what? You find what's in your
soul. You have to look outside the box. Okay. Into another box. Cities Skylines right now, deluxe edition is on sale for $14.99.
Yeah, it's the summer sale. For this
once in a week television event, a box on both your houses. but yeah, I'm trying to find the
Hi, I'm Greg, owner and founder of Steel Frame Spots. Due to unusually short fingers, which are a characteristic of my family line, I was unable to play spots at the elite level I would have liked to. Instead, I invested my energy into getting you the lowest prices possible on athletic gear. Unlike the local sports teams, you can count on us every year. I fight every day to get you the best deals. I'll never drop.
I mean, for me, I think I have.
Because low prices and my customers' happiness are not affected by the short fingers mentioned.
I think I have all the DLCs.
Just remember, when the game's on the line, who do you count on?
I think I have all of them. I'm not entirely sure, though. I could be wrong.
Check out our ad in the Weekly Nickel.
Come from the top. Looking out from a window on the 70th floor, the people below you look more like ants than individuals, all tirelessly working for a chance at the same high-rolling lifestyle. Where would we be without this kind of division? If there wasn't always someone earning more than you, why would anyone compete anymore? From up here, you can't help but take a step back and think righteous. If you're feeling good today, imagine listening to this next tune from a view like mine.
See. Wow, okay, so we've actually reached the 20,000 people mark. We've gotten over 21,000 people now.
Okay, so I have
Whoa, okay, that's why. You have what?
Let's see. So I have After Dark, Snowfall, Natural Disasters, Green Cities, Mass Transit, Concerts, Content Creator Pack, Europeans, Columbia, Industries, Synthetic Dawn Radio, Campuses, Park Life, and Plaza the Rock and Promenades.
Oh, okay.
Like, I only have 20 of them.
20 of, oh, okay, out of, wait, whoa, what is happening with the water? Can't be, are you guys really out of water again? Are out of waste treatment again? Well, I mean, how many are there? I kind of want to check how many.
Yeah.
Want to see how many DLCs there actually are for this game. All total there are 64.
Wow.
Like
not like their content creator packs, you know, radio packs and stuff like that. The only ones that I don't have are Calm the Mind Radio, On Air Radio, Jadia Radio, and the Africa in Miniature content creator packs. Which I just didn't seem like, I just didn't feel like I needed them. I saw that like the Africa pack was just sort of like it, they didn't really the reviews weren't that great.
Well, hotels and retreats come with two radios.
Yeah, I have them. I think I'm pretty sure I have them. Make this city a little more walkable.
How much is 3 FP? Oh. For a second there, I thought it was,
Is there? West Rainy River only has 689 people. Ouch. But oh my god, a lot of these have. Okay, so that one is 280, so we're probably going to have to. Oh.
But I mean, like, I love the game though. Like,
oh yeah, it's a fun city builder and it's kind of like a puzzle in a way, like, because you're trying to figure out like the best combination of like, oh, this is good. Okay, we should do this, and yeah. Oh, you know, it's like a. You know, trying to figure out the best way to deal with traffic, how to deal with happiness, how to satisfy people and the demand. You know, do I have any traffic that goes over this way? No. Okay. So. Thinking maybe we need to redo some of the bus systems because it's getting a bit overcrowded. Alright. But I want to do this first park area. Where is. We're going to make another. Oh, we're gonna make this a zoo.
I'll be right back.
Okay. So that's a question for you guys. For those that are watching, what would be your favorite what would be your favorite DLC that you like playing with? Like, and do you have all of them? And the other question is what ones do you think people should avoid? Creekside Metropolitan. What DLCs do you personally think that people should avoid? Like, Is there some that you don't like, or some that you think is like overpriced that you should wait for a DLC or something? Let us know what you think. So park, where's the zoo, main building? Zoom in gate. No. Come on, I saw green there. I know how wonky this looks. I don't care. We just need to get power over to it. Oh, it's going down, so we might. Going to put souvenir shop there. Mech. Okay, I did put it right. Okay. There's souvenir shop. Bay. The restrooms right there. Of course, you want to have them when you first walk in.
Yep.
So we are going to put, let's see, we'll start with like two or three different things. Let's put a zoo plaza right there. And then start us off, we will put a moose and reindeer enclosure. That
doesn't Santa need those reindeer for Christmas?
I guess he just donated them to the zoo.
Well, at least we get to see Rudolph.
See, what else can we put? Where else do we want to add? So we got the moose and reindeer. Birdhouse. We'll make that way go a bit. Move this down a bit. The only downside is the tracks are there. And I guess I don't see a reason why we can't redo this so that the tracks are on the other side of that.
Mm-hmm.
So we were gonna add a birdhouse there. There we go. And then
antelope enclosure. That would sort of work next to... Go. Oh yeah, I might want to add some water.
So there's four animals to drink.
Yeah, might want to. And then we'll just follow the paths. And I think we'll probably add another park here. Here. Still not large enough. Okay. Add a park there. Primrose. I think we'll probably add a station. Add a train station. That's a little janky, but I don't think we're gonna get it any better than that. Yeah, it's a little smoother. This will be Primrose train station.
So, I don't think I ever asked you, but what is your favorite thing about this game?
Well, compared to anything, or is it just what's my favorite?
I mean, there's really nothing I can compare it to, considering the other game hasn't come out yet.
Well, I mean, you could compare it to, Sim City, you can compare it to Cities XL, you can compare it to a lot of things, but if you want it to just be in general, I like, again, my first big thing I think that beats Sim City was the map sizes. They can be a lot bigger. If we were playing Sim City, literally this square right here would be all that we'd have to build on.
Yeah.
You know, we wouldn't be able to build all of this area and over here, you know, we wouldn't have that. Mm-hmm. It would just be this, trying to squish everything in.
Yeah.
You know? The other thing that I personally like is that it's, you know, not always online, like SimCity was. that building roads is very simple and easy. You know, you compare it to like Cities XL, which when you try to build a road, it will, like, the longer you make it, it will literally go down to like single digit frame rates. And it's just, it's absolutely horrible in my opinion, doing that. Like, it's so frustrating trying to build roads in Cities XL. I like the fact that, like, you can follow cars to wherever they're going and they'll actually go there. It's not just a simulated thing. There are actual agents there. You can follow a van like this and, you know, oh God. I must be tired or something. I can't... asking me all these questions. But these are agents that actually start from somewhere and actually have a destination, whereas, like, in Cities XL and, like, SimCity 4 and that, you'd have this van just driving around making weird turns, just being a visual aesthetic, you know? It's not, like, a real vehicle.
Yeah,
whereas
so
this,
it's not like, what do you call it?
It's just a visual representation.
Where the people walk. Like,
what do you mean? What?
Like, the people in Kingdoms Reborn, the way they walk. Or the way they try to carry something when
they have
floating there and their arms are down beside them walking.
They have telekinesis.
Yeah. I wish I had telekinesis. That would be so cool.
Just be able to move things with your mind.
Yeah. That would be my superpower.
That'd be very
cool.
Cool, awesome. Comfortable. It would not be so strenuous on you because you could just move it with your mind.
Yeah,
like, sure,
well,
you'd have to think. You'd have to think, but you could be sitting here and it's like, oh no, my water bottle is like over there on the dresser. Like, water bottle, come to me, and it'll just like float to
you. Flies at you. Although that would be dangerous if you're angry and you're standing in the kitchen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oof. I would not want to be someone. I would not want to be that.
Hmm.
Oh my cow. My God.
Okay, so we're gonna...
It's so hot in here right now.
Oh, yeah. I could feel it. Before the stream, what's the temperature outside right now? Ugh, 28. Wow. Is it feeling like an oven in there?
Yeah.
That's how you know it's hot.
I can't even feel it.
That's how you know it's hot, everybody, when even Sam here is dying of the heat. Well, Sam, if you need to come in for a second, you can come in. There's nothing stopping you. Just come in and...
Good.
Yeah, but get out of the heat for like a minute or two. Come on in. Say hi to the camera. Come on in and say hi to the camera for a few seconds.
Okay, if I can get up out of the chair, I will. Hold on.
But make sure you're dressed, please. All right, so we're gonna add a line.
Hi, guys.
Hey. Man.
How do I feel?
Wow, yeah, you're hot. Wow. Is it really that hot in your room? Let's see,
no,
can they? Let me, like, here. There you go. Now they can see you. Hey. Yeah. Yeah, actually, during break, I'm gonna go in and see how hot it is in there. That's insane. I mean, does it feel better in here?
Yeah.
If you need to,
it's
go
not
stand.
Even cold. Like,
warning. Like, experts predict an earthquake could hit the area.
Oh
soon.
No. We're about to have an earthquake.
But
as soon as you leave, we're about to have an earthquake. Yep.
Earthquake.
Yep.
No earthquake. Please.
Well, unfortunately, it doesn't look like we have a choice. So there's Sam, everybody. I'm gonna say this is the downtown. Oh God, how big is it? Oh, 4.7. 4.7 isn't too bad. We can deal with it. Where is? Okay. We're gonna call this the downtown criminal zone. Is it much cooler? Was it much cooler in here?
Yeah. I mean, I don't mind.
Oh no.
Uh-oh.
Where is it happening? Oh no! Not
no!
The downtown again!
No!
Don't panic!
The downtown again! Why? Why is it always the downtown? Oh my God!
Oh my
God!
Wow!
Oh, that's.
Oh, like, that's a lot. That's not
We're going to have to redo this whole thing. Is it done? Oh, no, I forgot to... Did I... Oh, wow. I'm evil. I never, I didn't, tell everybody to go hide in the bunkers.
Yeah. How many people did we lose?
Doesn't look like we should check. 188. So not horrible.
Yeah.
Not horrible. You know, it could have been much, much, much worse. But still, it means we have to rebuild this entire area.
Yep.
I mean, I guess the, it gives us a chance to redo everything.
Yeah.
Need be. Let's redo this.
But at least it was just a small part. Not like a... Not like everything.
Oh, like before?
Yeah. Like when we had that tsunami.
Which one?
Second one? Or was that the
Both
first one?
Both of them. Both of them just completely destroyed the entire area. No, we're gonna upgrade and take the moment now to upgrade this road to a collector. We're gonna have to make that road. We'll have to make that road there clean again, and then... Oh, and then... Or hopefully the... God. Yeah, this is really not good. Oh my God. Are we gonna have to redo this whole line?
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah, we're gonna have to redo this whole line, guaranteed. Okay. Yeah, there's no way of avoiding it. Downtown Farmingdale line is gonna disappear because we're gonna do it. One. Oh, please tell me it didn't. Oh, that's why.
They're coming up.
Okay, which means it's almost break time for us. I'm gonna put that there. Add stop. Add stop. And add stop. Go. About to put one there. There.
Right.
All right, so this is downtown Farmingdale line.
You know, if we, if I was to do a town, like, would it be easier for me to do, well, no, because they're not available yet.
What?
I was going to say, would it be easier just to put the train tracks in first and then build the town around it?
Well, train tracks cost money, like, a lot.
Yeah.
So you'd need to have the population for it. That's the thing.
Right.
Like, if you're playing with everything off and everything, like, and no money mod, like, where, you know, you don't have any restrictions.
Yeah.
You can have, you can do that if you want to. I mean, there's nothing stopping you from doing that.
Right.
Like, do you know how to get it? Like, how to...
It's in settings, isn't it?
Content, I think. Think it's, Content Manager, I think it's called. Okay. Yeah, it's called Content Manager. Go there and then look under Mods. Okay. So, oh, wait. No, we need, I'm gonna put some extra parking. Yeah, I can't wait to see how, like, the extra parking is going to affect things.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you need to provide enough parking for people to, like, to go places, because it affects... it affects what people are going to want to do and where they're going to want to go. If there's not enough parking, they're not going to want to go to any of the locations that you built. You know what I mean? So you're going to have to accommodate them. That's why you gotta build these parking lots. But unfortunately, parking lots in here are just parks, so they just come here to visit like they're a normal park. So they'll come here and be like, oh, this is beautiful. This is a nice little park. That's just full of cars.
Yeah.
There's a lot of uncertainty in life nowadays. Uncertainty about housing, steady work, appearing successful in the eyes of your neighbors. Now that anti-anxiety medication is more heavily regulated than ever, what's a young entrepreneur to do when their day isn't going?
Oh, there we go. We've got another academic work, product claims. The innovative alternative to regular rope spreads up the tying process and resources products 50% more tightly. Ha 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 ha. All right, so got plus one academic works, 678 students, 175 campus attractiveness. So let's see. Let's take a look. Campus wrong thing. So we've reached our campus attractiveness. Now we just need to get one more academic work, and we need 141 more 141 more students. I think that's doable. We're okay, right? Ooh. Oh, it also destroyed our water.
Oh no.
So we gotta adjust the pipes here. Oh, I didn't do it correctly. Yeah, we kind of need to... Actually, I'm going to fix this. I want them to slow down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this into a more of an artillery... I can't think of the arterial road here. And I'm gonna fix the TMPE thing. Connections. One can go here. Oh. Oh yeah, I forgot about the buses here. We're gonna have to fix this, because it's... Wait, why is the... Why is the tram system... There we go.
I think they found the bed.
Okay. And then I'm just gonna go like this. I just want to make sure that the water's been updated. Make sure it goes away. Just wanted to be sure, did we make sure it was 8 o'clock and not 7:30? Oh yeah, okay, good. Okay, so we will take a quick break and we will be right back for to continue the stream. Hopefully no more disasters, but I might have just jinxed us.
Sure.
Hey, at least it would provide some entertainment for you guys, right?
Yeah.
Not that we aren't already entertaining.
Sure.
Anyway, anyway, we'll be back.
We got about 3,000 gold, so I have $12,000 in my bank account, ready to go. So, will third time be the charm?
The tulip, resource, and I have none.
Happy birthday.
Aw, thank you.
We're back. Let me just unmute Sam. You there?
Yep.
Okay, good. Yeah, I can attest to Sam's pain. Her room is absolutely like on fire. Like, is pretty much an oven. Holy crap. But there is one thing I'm gonna do before we continue. We're gonna redo these bridges because we're gonna make a service road here. I thought about it, and you know what? It'll relieve track it. Track it? What is track it? We're gonna relieve traffic on this highway. Oh, I'm also gonna change the radio station because I've heard enough of it. We'll listen to country because we haven't heard that one in a while.
Yay, country.
Okay. So it should relieve some of the traffic on this highway. Hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully.
I say should, but doesn't mean it will. Yeah. Oh, and it's doing this thing again. I hate it. I hate it when it does this. Makes the road go all the makes the track go wonky. Where is the... There we go. Oh. That's horrible. The bad thing is, too, is I may have to redo the entire... The track or the line over again is I accidentally deleted this part of the track, so it's like, oh, you didn't you made the line already? Well, we can't figure out how to get to the next station because you deleted the track. Then I'm gonna redo the I want to redo some of the bus lines because the lines are getting a little long, and which is why there's like so many riders. Mm-hmm. So if we can make the lines smaller, even if we were to have more lines, like smaller lines compared to a couple of large lines.
Yeah.
Use the move it. Okay, hold on one second. I've got to get the. It is lonely in my ghost town now. Everything is like you left it that day. Yeah. The sound of silence is killing. Nothing here can set me free. All the streets that we've been walking along, and all the places, yeah, that were you and me. But the I'm gonna have to use move it to. This is one of the mods that I definitely recommend people get, because the game will produce like really wonky looking roads, kind of like this. Like trains would not like this. So if you can make it smoother for them, you know, if you can make it smoother, and look more realistic, like, it'd be, like, it goes a long way. It's like, yeah, it's more of a cosmetic thing, but, you know, it just makes it more realistic and immersive. Okay, yeah, that's not so bad. That's okay. So, where's the bus system? Okay, what line is this? I wanted to. Where's the... Where's the bus? Where did the bus go? Where did the bus go? Wow, okay. Why is that not working? Nothing here can ever make you right. Come on. What is this? What are you doing? Okay. Why is that having such a hard time figuring out what? Okay, I'm very confused at why that is doing that. Like, why is this having issues? I'm not understanding. See, it's doing it again. Oh, this is so annoying. I'm really confused at what's going on. I don't understand why it's doing that. I guess we're gonna have to redo this line, because it is confusing the hell out of me. Oh god. Yes. Delete the line. I'll just redo it. We're redoing the entire transport network, it looks like, everybody, so I guess starting over from the beginning. Oh, that's why. Oh, whoops. I thought this was okay. I think this needs a train track.
Two-lane road with medium train tracks.
Where is just two-lane road train? There we go. Oh, okay, good. So good. It's fixed, so now we can redo this entire line. Okay. You know what? No. We'll go here and then all the way around. What? What is... Okay, there we go. Wait. There we go. Complete line. There we go. So the... Forest... This is Forest Park 2... Oh! Wait a minute. Oh! Kinda need to... Add, And then this side will come in and make a right. There, and then one right here. There. So that will be Forest Park.
It's Super Salmon Days down at Fish Brothers. For a limited time, bring in any fish and get a child salmon entree.
25 25 stops. We're also gonna change. What?
And I mean any fish. Got a swordfish lying around? Bring it in. Got a goldfish you're sick of feeding? Bring it in.
Oh my
God,
that is.
Bring it in.
We'll that is horrible.
With the rest of them. What we do with the fish is nobody's business but ours. Just enjoy okay. Your salmon $8.99 with our famous stew. So, welcome on into Fish Brothers Seafood Themed Restaurant, where everything's a great catch.
Last year, Horse Economy 3 smashed PC sales records and took the industry by storm. Now the hit Equine Economic Simulator has a new expansion that delves into the cutthroat world of real estate. Horse Economy 3.
What is one is this again?
Can you work your way from lowly horse to be the head of a major real estate empire? Can you spin your holdings into a billion-dollar conglomerate? Can you work your way under the fence and out of your pen?
Okay.
And on
we're gonna delete this line.
Spreadsheets have never been hotter. Pre-order her now and get a free horse hat. Horse Economy 3, stable markets. Buy low, sell
high. Delete line, yes. Redo it all.
The last song reminded me of my days on the ranch. My mama had a saying that went, if the chicken ain't clucking, don't offer it eggs. Come to think of it, I'm not sure what she meant by that. The chickens darn near never stop clucking, and they almost never seem to want to eat eggs. Maybe it was more.
I wonder why.
In fact, the chickens never really liked mom. So I wouldn't invest too much in her opinions about chicken care. But hey, family is family. Well, enough about me. Let's play another song.
Did you hear what he was saying? Sam?
Kind of. Sorry, I have my mic up.
You had your... Oh. Yeah, are you even watching, or what's...
I am, but I was chewing, and I didn't want it to come through.
Oh, okay. Okay, so you have some manners, thank you. he said, you know, his mom always had a saying that if, wait, what did he say? He said something like, if the chickens aren't clucking, don't give them eggs.
Yeah.
But they never stop clucking, and they never seem to want to eat eggs. It's like,
yeah.
I wonder why.
Because they don't eat eggs, they make eggs.
That's the point.
It's like a little bit of
cannibalism for you.
It's like the chickens looking at it going, Why are you giving something I just put out?
It's like, why do you want me to eat my kid?
Yeah.
I think...
Or the chicken singing, I am offended.
Yeah, probably. Okay. So, I redid that one because it just looked really bad. There's a bus line going down that way. I'm going to change. I'm gonna. You know what? We can let the thing go. We can get a little more demand going, but. Goes along there, stops there. Oh God, what is this song?
My God, I think I know it. But it kind of sounds like, what do you call it,
It, well, it's like...
There's a hint of a kid song in it.
Well, it's like, it mainly... It's a song that Paradox did, right? So it's
right,
like,
yeah.
But it's still the, oh gosh, it's so stereotypically country. Like you immediately get the feeling that it's country. Like the sound of it is like, yeah. The other thing I'm looking forward to with this, with the sequel, is the fact that you can now make waypoints for like bus lines. So sometimes you get this like wonkiness over here. Do you see like the weirdness that is the like? Well, now with waypoints, you can control where the bus route goes. Like, you know, precisely where it goes. Like, if you wanted to avoid a tricky intersection, all you do is plop a waypoint down and have it go there and like put it as part of the line, and boom, you got yourself a waypoint. You know, you get it to go where you want. But in this game, it makes some really weird decisions, and it's really frustrating that you have to add stops where you don't want to add stops to make, like, just to make it, you know, make it look good, you know, like, have it go where you want it to go.
Yeah.
It's time to expand the Farmingdale a little bit. I haven't touched Farmingdale in forever.
Thank you.
add some of these, add a section there. And then to build out, we're gonna buy these two tiles. Oh, when did it... That's why they weren't popping in. Kinda gotta press the unpause button. Oh wow, that's a big farming area. Okay, that's good. Oh wow, we got a lot of oil down this way. As much as I want to, take advantage of it. I don't want to destroy the environment here. Let's build Creekside up a little bit more right here. Let's see, how is this zoo doing? An advertisement campaign, animal ethics, so we're being nice to the animals. Kind of be a little mean if we were just being very neglectful of our animals.
Yeah.
Alright. Zoo. insect enclosure. Ooh, do we want to put it next to the bird enclosure? Because what if the birds get out and start eating the insects?
Oh, jeez.
That wouldn't be too good.
Nope.
That's okay, though. We'll put it there. Go. Oh, and we will add what else? A bison enclosure. This seems to be like a woody themed area over here, so. Although, how big is the bison enclosure? Oh wow, I think it just fits. So we'll put that, the, there. Oop. We'll see. Let's take a look at some of them. Oh, wow. Oh, there are the bisons. Do they have
eyes?
Okay, do they have eyes? Like...
Obviously not.
No, I'm...
They don't have eyes, no. And their markings are moving all over the place.
What?
Their markings were moving all over the place.
Hmm. Okay, what about the deer enclosure?
Oh, dear.
Oh. Yep, there's the reindeer. Okay. What about the inside, bird? Oh, this is the plaza. I like that. That's cute. That's funny. What about over here? Whoa. Oh, little, swans. Nice. Or ducks, whatever they are. Oh, you can't see inside the insect enclosure, unfortunately. Damn. Whoops. Okay. Ooh. Traffic is starting to back up. That's not good. Still got about half an hour to go. It change up the grid a little bit. Greek side looks like it's gonna be full of farmers, like Farmingdale. It seems like this is what it's what our Rainy River specializes in is agricultural products.
Why shouldn't Farmingdale do that?
No, I mean the city as a whole.
I know.
They'll play your favorite hits, like, give out great prizes, and Farmingdale does. I mean, it's where all the most of the agricultural stuff is, but the
gaze at a
like lock overall the overall
at the city zoo, you can experience
the overall like weekend to meet our newest agricultural stuff or the overall industry of the city seems to be a lot of agriculture. After that, take a gander at another new species. So we're going to build an underpass to make it more walkable for these guys to go down under the
get a free handful of pellets to feed the fish. Limit 4 per family while supplies last. We'll look forward to seeing you where the animals live in rooms painted to look like home. The City Zoo.
Go. We'll have an underpass there.
Cowboys, this is Country Road Radio.
That in. Elementary. Put a high school right here. My heart is beating faster than mine. Rose High School. Actually, we should see how this bridge looks like. Whether if it's is it too? No, it doesn't seem like it's too like steep. No, looks okay.
Rock just cut off everyone.
Yeah, it's one of the main gripes. Like another big thing about this this game that a lot of people want fixed is the AI, the way it like will cut over 3 lanes to get to their destination. It's like, yeah, they want to kill each other basically.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, look at that. That is amazing.
Oh wow.
That mountain in the background, I love it.
Kind of like when we were in Las Vegas.
Yeah, yeah. It does. Every time I look at you, the moon lake, you let your mind. Lucky. Sorry, guys, I'll try to stop singing. This one's actually a good song. This actually is a catchy song. I don't mind it. I'm not normally a fan of country, but... We gotta get some population. We haven't been focusing on I just want to get some demand. We haven't had a lot of, we haven't had a lot of, like, demand for housing at all. I'm hoping this will change it. See, are we any closer to... Oh, we're actually losing students, so we gotta... Public library. Why did we make these roads so curvy? There. Okay, so we've got a lot of capacity for high school. It's elementary school that we gotta... Well, that's a bit confusing. Where should I put this when everyone has access to it, but here maybe? I see the sky start shifting. I see the dawn is here. I have a sense that my warmer days are near. Let's see if we can get some demand coming in. Okay. Now, I'm thinking here. Oh. Actually, to alleviate some of the traffic. Oh, I already did put a taxi stand there. What about over here? Did I put a taxi stand over here? No, didn't. So, put it there. Also, put some housing over here. Also try to get some more people coming in. Industry. some commercial demand right here. We're going to redo this area. Although, no, we didn't. Okay.
Everyone's like, what happened to the road?
Yeah, I know, but we're going to lower the road just a little bit. Yeah, I hope to, like, I'd really like to see as well the terrain tools being just a little bit easier, and the ability, like, the, I hope that it's easier to build overpasses and underpasses in the game, because, like, having to do this every single time is really tedious. I mean, I know I don't have to do it. Like, I don't have to, I don't have to make a proper round, a proper overpass or underpass, but it's just, I like the realism of it. Actually, you know what? I am going to... I'm gonna redo that, because... Thank you. attach this one here.
We've been making the best in mobile phones for over 20 years. How did we get there? By putting ringtones in every commercial that makes you think your phone is ringing. Whether you have a new phone, an old phone, or just leave it on vibrate, we make sure you always hear your phone in our commercials. It's our way of saying, we hear you. So don't be silenced when opportunity calls, pick it up. It's for you. Akio Mobile.
The wait is over. It's finally here. Friday night chili bowling at Andy's Bowling Alley. Every Friday night, anyone who buys at least two games of bowling gets a free bowl of chili. So don't wait. Book a lane now. Due to recent incidents, the chili will only be distributed at the end of your visit. That way you can enjoy it wherever you want. In a park, at home, or on a construction site. In the meantime, you'll have all the fun that bowling can provide. So come on back and be reminded that you're not actually that good at bowling.
This one is gonna curve this way. Oh god, that looks ugly. Nope.
Improvisational cowboy sound like yippee ki yay.
Is Chipper still blue or am I going colorblind? Actually,
you can't. Nope, it's pink.
Okay. You're the expert. So I'm not losing my mind.
No.
Okay.
As well, you have to have a mind to lose, to have a like. You have to have a mind in order to lose it, so.
Mean, but okay.
What?
I said mean, but okay.
Well, you know how I am.
Oh, I do know how you are. You know how I am, too.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so I'm gonna adjust that. No, I don't like that. No. I don't like how it... I don't think I'd be able to make it... smoother. I want that smoother. I was gonna say, is game? Are you frozen or something? And somehow it made it worse. Why? Why is it doing that?
I should drive you.
I guess it's about as good as I'm gonna get it. I'm not really gonna. The road's gonna go under. I guess the road can go under the highway and then out to over here. But we can do that next episode because I know we're getting pressed for time, I think. Ooh, we got about 15, 20 minutes.
Yes.
Actually, I mean, I guess, since we only have 15, 20 minutes, I guess we could do it.
Although,
I was talking to an old friend. Losing citizens.
I thought we would have hit 25,000 people by now.
That's very strange. Put in a helicopter. Do we? Oh, there's police. Okay, so can I? Alright, we're gonna delete this. Medical. This is gonna be like the helicopter area. I hate to say it, but next time we're also gonna have to probably build a. We'll probably have to build like a highway over this way to allow for Farmingdale to bypass this housing area. And that's what I'm like, because otherwise the farming area is stuck. Like,
yeah.
It no longer really has access to this.
Mm-hmm.
Unless we build a. I mean, we could build a track that goes out. Okay. So this is going to be the border of the, this is going to be the border of the farming area. The train station right here.
Some other day, rain is falling, The clouds are gray, but I can't stop feeling this way. I want you back, I love you. You know my love is true. I give you all my love and I'm still in love with you. I want you back, I love you. You know my love is true. I give you all my love and I'm still in love with you. I want you back, I love you. You know my love is true. I give you all my love and I'm still in love with you. Rain is falling, the clouds are gray. I give you all my love and I'm still in love with you.
Okay, there we go. And then whoever they got to do the music for this, like, for their radio stations, did an amazing job.
Yeah.
Like, this sounds like real country, like, old style. Like, do you get the feel of that? Like...
Yeah.
That this is, like, real country music?
Mm-hmm.
Just go like that for now. But yeah, I like that. That's the other thing I really liked about this game, about the game, is the music. Like, the music can really make or break a game, and I think they did an amazing job with this.
I wonder if they expected it to be as popular as me.
Oh, they were hoping, like, what, the game as a whole?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I'm sure they did. I'm sure they were hoping so, because, like, originally Paradox wasn't gonna allow Colossal Order to build, like, to build a city-building game. Mm. Because of how big, like, because at the time, SimCity was a, like, they cornered the market. Like, SimCity was the game, right? Like, the city building game. They had, like, a monopoly over the game. But once SimCity crashed, Paradox Interactive was like, yeah, go for it. Like, they green-lighted it because they saw an opportunity. Like, that's the thing. That's probably something you gotta really hand to Paradox, is they did, like, the smartest company move you could ever make. And that was... seeing that your potential competitor that had, like, cornered the market, fail, and then say, okay, perfect opportunity, let's make this game. You know, like, they made a really smart move in greenlighting City Skylines at the time they did. So they were never like they. That's why, like, beforehand, Colossal Order had done what is it called? The Cities in Motion franchise, which was a transportation style game where you had a city and you had to provide the transportation for it. You know what I mean? Like, you had to provide, like, proper transportation for it. But the, so they wanted to make a, city builder. But, like I said, SimCity had cornered the market at the time, so Paradox was not really sure about them doing that. They were not really comfortable with them doing that because of, because they were afraid it was going to fail because of how small they were. At the time, back in 2015, this game, the developers who made this game only had 20 or 13 people working on it. There were only 13 people at the company. Yeah. That's crazy, isn't it? Yeah, they only had, 13 people working on the game, working at that development company, and so to see them make such a successful game, you know, in that sort of short amount of time, was, and completely beat, sell really well, but corner the market themselves is an amazing feat. That's very rare. That is something you definitely have to commend them for. They were able to come back, completely take on a AAA company that had cornered the market for so long and completely steal their thunder and corner the market themselves. Yeah. That is amazing. There we go. Forster has... So now they can directly import and export their products. They can directly import and export their products directly through the train rather than it being you know what I mean? Being I may have to dezone these buildings here because we may want to turn this area over here into a warehouse area. That stores the farming products.
Yeah.
We can make that decision next time.
Yep.
I know that sounds like I'm too lazy, but truthfully, we really don't have that much time left, I don't think. We've got 7 minutes. Yeah, we got... Or no! It's 9:29 now.
Yeah.
So, we're close to being out of time, so... Mm-hmm. We'll give it, 3 to 5 more minutes and... See how distributed that is. Good. Yeah.
Driving towards the holy ground.
Anderson's. Yup, look, see how... That's the problem with it. That's why I'm thinking next time we will start with, like, making a highway go this way so that they have direct access to the... better access to the highway so they don't have to go through Creekside. Alright, so we are almost... we'll let these buildings come in. In, and then see how many people live in Parkview. 2562. Okay, last academic works plus one, so we've got the amount of academic works we need. Students 628, so that's negative 50. Okay, so we really need to work on our education next year, or next week, not next year. Ugh.
Yeah, I was gonna be like, wait, what?
And then recognize, so we're still recognized. Okay, so if I remember correctly, we made it to, yeah, so we've gotten two out of the three things. We need to work on our the students next time. We still can't get up to 23,000. That's annoying. You're 22,777. So close. Alright, well. Put these guys in and then. I don't think we're gonna reach it, but that's all right. Okay, that is all the time we have, guys, so I'm gonna save it here. We did fairly well. I think we got like 3,000 more people in. Primrose grew by a little bit. We've started expanding Farmingdale and Creekside. We had an earthquake hit us. There we go. And we've got a zoo now. So yeah, I think that's pretty good. You know, I think we've done good for us so far. So we'll see what happens next time. I'm gonna save the game here and then bring myself back to the main screen. Okay. I am very happy that the internet did not cause us issues today.
Yeah.
Very happy. Let me just have a drink before I say my final spiel, which is the same. If you guys were here at the start and you already heard all this, you guys can easily go if you need to. Because it's the same stuff you heard before. But quickly, if you haven't already and you watched this live stream and you enjoyed it and you want to help support me here and you want to show that you guys and you want to encourage me to continue this live stream playthrough of City Skylines, you know, just a few months before the sequel comes out, if you want to see us continue to build this city here, it'd be great
I would greatly appreciate it. It would mean a lot to me if you guys could follow me here on Twitch. It means a lot. I just had a new follower here. Let me just again look at it. Their name was Metzmerize, I think it says. It's spelled Metzmerize. So very, very interesting name. In a good way. In a good way. Very interesting name. But thank you. So thank you again for the follow. Like I said, it means a lot. It still says that I only have 30 followers, which is very strange. So I'll go off of that, though. I am still within 10 followers of reaching my goal. Here, let me move. 10 followers of reaching my goal of 40 followers. It means a lot. It's the first one. First goal that I've ever put on Twitch, and once I reach it, I may do something special. Don't know what I can do. It'll be very limited. It'll be a very limited thing, but I could see myself doing something special for reaching that goal. So if you want to see me reach it and find out what it is, please give me a follow here on Twitch. It means a lot, especially as me being a small streamer and this just being a hobby for right now, just wanting to entertain people and having fun and just enjoying my time playing video games, you know, that I like, something that I enjoy doing and I hope to continue doing for a long time. If you have any suggestions for ways that I can improve the stream, any games you want to see me play, anything that will get people to come on and watch the streams, anything that will get you guys to come back and watch the streams again, and you know, have fun and enjoy hanging out, let me know. Put all of your suggestions and all of your ideas and constructive criticism and stuff like that over here in the Twitch chat or in the suggestion box below. There again, you can put whatever ideas that you have, and I will do my best to look at them and look through all of them and see which ones I can implement and which games we could see ourselves playing. Again, you can let us know any games that you think would be fun to watch, any games that you think will get people to come on and watch. Because, you know, like I say, almost every stream, I have my own ideas. I really do. I have my own ideas that I want to implement. I have my own, I have ideas or games that I want to play, but I want to hear from you guys. You guys are the ones I'm half doing this for. Half of it is for me. Half of it is for you guys, you know, because I always say like, it's for you guys, but you know, if some of it wasn't for me, I mean, why would I even be here? Right? Like what would be the point? What would be the point of this? If you know, I just did it for other people. So yeah. It shows that by having this half for me, it shows that I enjoy the game, playing the games and entertaining people just as much as, you know, people watching the stream enjoys it, you know? So yeah. But anyway, yeah, I have my own ideas, but I want to hear from you guys. I want to know what you will get you guys to come back. What games would you like to see? Suggestions do you have that would improve the stream so much that will get you guys to come back for another live stream? If you want to stay up to date with everything that's going on, any changes that I make, anything that's going on with this hobby in general, you can find me here over on Twitter at Allegis9611. 0996. That is where I post all of these streams after they my script just went way off key there. My Twitter handle is not where you can find all of these live streams. It's where you can stay up to date with everything that's going on with this hobby. Any news, any updates to the schedule, whenever I go live, stuff like that, you can find me here, find me there on my Twitter handle. You can stay most up to date, the fastest there. So go over and follow me if you want to stay up to date. If you want to support me over on YouTube, I do have a YouTube page.
Allegis Plays. That is where I post all of these live streams after they premiered here. They usually go up within the first 24 to 48 hours after they premiered here. It really just depends on the internet connection, the how long it takes to render, the internet quality at the time, YouTube, just a lot of factors. Yeah, if I'm busy, like if the next day I just don't find the time. Luckily, I will have the time tomorrow to edit it, but yeah, it should be up either tomorrow or Wednesday. It's just because, you know, I know the Twitch likes to delete these live streams like 7 days after they've premiered here. So they're in the VOD list for like 7 days and then they delete them. But over on YouTube, they never get deleted. Every live stream that I've ever done here is still up over there. So if you want to go check them out, you want to check all of these live stream, all of these live streams from the Rainy River series out, and you haven't seen them yet, they're over on YouTube. So go watch them if you haven't already, and you enjoy this series. If you want to help me out over there, one of the best ways to do that is to subscribe to the channel. It helps build a community over there. Like I said, it's greatly appreciated. And it helps build a community. Hit the bell notification so that you're notified whenever I upload a video. Other great ways to help me is to like the live stream so that the content gets pushed up a little bit more in the algorithm. You know, even if it's just a little bit, for a small streamer like me, it's a lot. So yeah, every little bit helps. Also, share the live stream so that it gets the word out and, you know, a couple more people will see it and maybe like it, you know. But yeah, so I hope that you guys enjoyed it, enjoyed tonight's stream. If you're watching this from YouTube, come over to Twitch, come over and hang out, you know, come over and watch it. Yeah, we don't fight. Come over and watch it live, you know, cause we do have a lot of fun playing these games, and it's, to me, it's entertaining. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of people find this kind of stuff entertaining, just casual games, casual people, you know, yeah, when you're in good company, it just makes things a lot better. So come on over to Twitch sometime. Check us out. Come have fun. But until then, Wednesday will be the final Humankind live stream. My friend Matt and I, we have like 37 turns left in that game. So I'm pretty sure we're going to finish that game on Wednesday. If not, we'll have to finish it next week. But that will be as long as he's available, because he may not be available. But as long as he is, it will be at 5:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Again, I know the after show card says 6:30, but that is only if Matt is not available. If Matt is not available, depending on what I decide to do to replace that stream for the week, it will be at 6:30. But if not, it will be 5:30 Eastern Standard Time. So come check us out. Until then, I've been your host, Chris, aka Allegis. Sam, thank you for joining me tonight. As always.
You're uh-oh. Welcome.
Okay, good. I thought you went to the washroom there or like something while we were still live. I'm like, hey, wait a minute, we're not offline yet. We're not offline yet.
Nope, I'm still here.
All right, good. Sorry for listening to. Sorry, you have to listen to my whole script every time. But yeah, thank you for joining me. Hopefully, you'll be available Friday to continue our Kingdoms Reborn stream, and next week when we'll probably finish this. City Skylines series, possibly.
Yeah.
All right, but also thank you guys for watching, and we will see you guys on Wednesday. Well, I will. I will. And then depending, yeah. But whatever, yeah. Go into the outro right now. Before I can't stop talking.